Hi, my name is Gloria Lee, and I'm a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team.
Hi, I am Ravi Venapusa. I'm also a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team here at Microsoft.
In the previous videos, we described how Windows Logon worked with Azure AD. In this video, we'll explain how this authentication extends to provide single sign-on to native apps and web apps. Please know that the authentication to Azure AD is the same for both Azure AD joined devices and Harbor Azure AD joined devices. So Ravi, can you walk us through how the Azure AD single sign-on works in Windows devices, please?
Happy to. First, let's take a look at how it works in native applications. And for this, we'll take a familiar example of your Outlook client trying to get your email from Exchange Online. This flow starts with Outlook requesting a token from the Web Account Manager, or WAM for short, a component on Windows that enables single sign-on. WAM is what we call a token broker that enables applications to get tokens using a common API. WAM forwards this request to Azure AD, but now it adds a primary refresh token to this request by signing it with the session key. If you remember from the previous video, the session key is a proof of position key provided by Azure AD when it issues the primary refresh token. This key is protected by the Trusted Platform Module, or TPM, a hardware crypto component on the device. Now, Azure AD does all the necessary validations. It validates the session key signature, validates the device and the user using the PRT, and issues an access token and a refresh token for Exchange Online to WAM. These tokens are encrypted by the session key to prevent unauthorized applications from gaining access. As these tokens are encrypted, WAM sends a request to Cloud AP to decrypt them before it can pass on to Outlook. Cloud AP now invokes the TPM to decrypt the tokens and issue them back to WAM. And finally, WAM passes the access tokens back to Outlook so that it can silently and seamlessly deliver an email. An important call out here is that WAM only provides the applications with the access token and not the refresh token. The refresh tokens are securely encrypted and stored by WAM to prevent unauthorized access. When the application needs a new access token, then WAM uses that refresh token to request access token in place of using a PRT.
Great call out on the WAM information. So Ravi, now that we know how it works for native apps, can you explain how it works for browser and web applications?
Of course. So for browsers, the process is slightly different, as it starts with injecting a cookie derived from the PRT called the PRT cookie. Let's go through how it works by taking the Edge browser as an example. When a user wants to access a web application in a browser, the browser loads the URLs for Azure AD and invokes a native client host to get a cookie. This native client validates that these URLs belong to Microsoft Identity and makes a request to Cloud AP to get a PRT cookie. Cloud AP will create this PRT cookie, again signed with the session key, which we mentioned earlier is the proof of position key for Azure AD. Then it sends back the PRT cookie to the native client host, which in turn returns it back to the browser. The browser now includes this PRT cookie as part of the request to Azure AD to get a token for the user's application. Azure AD validates the PRT, the session key signature, and issues a session cookie for the application to sign the user in. Now the application seamlessly signs the user in and user can access their resources without needing to sign in again.
Thank you, Ravi. We hope you found this video useful. We'll be adding more videos on different topics like authentication, multi-factor authentication, governance, and many more. Please see the description below to the links and diagram used in this video and other useful information. Thank you.
Thank you for listening in.